ASTM D882 and ISO 527-3 are common testing standards used for measuring the tensile properties of thin films. Due to the thin nature of these materials, accurate measurement of specimen dimensions is critical. Specimen length and width are dependent on expected elongation and desired results, but typically start at 1 inch wide and range between 4 and 10 inches long. It's important to check with the standard to verify the proper dimensions for your material. Three measurements should be averaged to determine the specimen's width and thickness. A digital micrometer is a suitable option for taking these measurements. Grips must be able to accommodate the thinning of the specimen as the test progresses. Pneumatic side action grips are the preferred gripping solution because they provide a consistent clamping force. Jaw face selection depends on the thickness and strength of the material. Rubber or smooth faces are the most commonly used. Specimen alignment is critical, and specimen reinsertion should be avoided. Repeatability and throughput can be improved by using an alignment and insertion device such as Instron's Precision Specimen Loader. It is recommended to use an extensometer for calculating modulus results. Any extensometer used requires a measurement accuracy of plus or minus 1% error. Instron's AVE Advanced Video Extensometer is a non-contacting solution ideally suited for measuring strain in delicate specimens such as thin films. Key results for ASTM D882 include strain at break, breaking factor, tensile strength, yield strength, and elongation at yield. Key results for ISO 527-3 include nominal strain at yield and break, tensile stress at yield, and tensile stress at break. While this video will hopefully provide some general insight into this topic, we always recommend connecting with your local sales engineer to discuss your specific needs. For more information, visit our website or contact us with any questions. Thanks for watching.